students, how are you doing? I think you are gearing up for some change. Do you see that word here? A change. From 2 years, we have been hearing and doing changes, isn't it? Yeah, we changed from offline to online. Now there is a big change. Yes, we are going to look into that change. What is that change? Yes, that is the semester system, isn't it? Yes. So this is the first change that we heard of. Okay. After this came the second change, that the pattern completely changed. Okay. So the first one is semester system and the second one is MCQs. Yes, multiple choice questions. Now we have no clue. It's not that we don't have a clue. We have had MCQs earlier, but then to have an all MCQ paper is pretty difficult. Yes, we are not geared for it, but we are always ready to adapt to changes. We are smart children, isn't it? You are smart, you are brilliant, and you can definitely adhere and adapt to multiple choice questions. So, but we need to know the methods, okay? The tips. Don't you need tips to crack multiple choice questions and to get full score? Yes, it is possible. Do you know you can score full? Yeah, I'm going to give you some tips on how to score full. Come on. The first thing is a healthy breakfast. Yes, before you crack an exam, you definitely need to eat well. Some people say that when you eat well, you feel sleepy. No, it's not so. You need to eat protein food. Do you know that? Because that boosts your energy. Just like how boost will be the secret of your energy, protein-rich food will boost your energy. The second thing is drink a lot of water. It's very important. If you drink water, it keeps you hydrated. It keeps your brain energized. You see, you need your brain to be sharp for these MCQs. Got it? So you need to have a good breakfast and don't forget the water. Next, we go to time. It's very important. We have 40 questions and you have 1 hour, right? Or accordingly, whatever the number of questions are, what you could do is definitely remember you will have 5% of tough questions or 10% of tough questions. You can't divide the questions and the time equally. Okay, so have shorter time for the easy questions and have a particular time. Say if it's 1 hour, have half an hour for the tough questions. Okay, so that's planning your time. The next one is to attempt everything in an order. Okay, now what you do is you have a pencil in your hand. It's not possible to always attend everything. Okay, supposing you know question 1, okay, you have finished. Question 2, you have finished. Third one, you are doubtful. You don't know. See here, this fellow is scratching his head. He doesn't know what to answer, okay? So what you do, don't waste time, but just skip over and go to the fourth one. But here, you just put a small tick with a pencil. So that's what you're going to do in this point. Okay. The next one is you read the questions carefully. It's very important, children. You have reading time. And many of you all panic, and you just go fast and you read half the question, you leave half the question. But here is something that you need to really do. You have to read your questions very carefully. See, some statement, for example, it says, pick out the point that is not correct, that doesn't adhere to covalent bonding, that doesn't adhere to group 2. And what do? You go and pick up things that are in favor and not against. So it's just the opposite. Why? Because you have not read properly. Okay, so reading is very important. Next, you have to decide the correct answer. See, come on, you have only 6 to 7 chapters. In each of the subjects, it's only 5-6 chapters, isn't it, for the first semester? And you have ample time to prepare yourself. Now, you have prepared and you see the question. Don't look into the options. Don't look into A, B, C, D. Don't look into any of the options. you think about the answer. While reading, you think about the answer. What should I answer? What should I do? You determine, you decide, okay, this should be the answer. That should be in your mind, okay? Right. Next, you go to the next one. When you decide the answer, always, you know, when you think of something good, there will be something bad that comes to distract us. Right? Just like that, here also, you have something called diverters or distractors. Supposing option A, okay, in this case, option A is the right answer. So B, C, D, they look like the right answer, but they are not the right answers. Okay? So what are they called? They are called diverters or distractors. They look very much alike. So you really, it tries to confuse you. Okay, they are confusion makers rather. But when you have already decided the right answer, you have determined to tick the right answer, you don't have to worry about this, but just ignore it. Okay, then you go to the last point. Don't forget, you have to go back. Because remember, you have some into marks like this where you weren't sure, it was looking a little bit tough and confusing. Now you go back to those questions, okay? So you go all the left out questions one by one. So you have time allotted for it. So go to that and start doing that. Then the last important thing is attempt all questions. Now you'd ask me, you said that if you're not sure, don't do it. Why should we attempt all questions? Yes, that is where we can sometimes. Remember, children, after doing all these things, if you still aren't sure of certain questions and you still have to answer, the point says attempt all questions, then what do? You will make a brilliant guess. Okay? There's nothing wrong. That's at the end, remember, not in the beginning. Don't try to throw dice right in the beginning. Right in the beginning, it's from what you have learned, and what you do not know for sure, you can brilliantly guess certain things and do it, okay? So these are the tips I want to give you before you start cracking your multiple choice questions. And now what you should do is, before you set yourself ready for the exam, you start going chapter-wise, you write down the possible questions and the possible options and start preparing yourself. You will definitely do extremely well. Remember, this is a very easy way of scoring marks, okay? Wish you all the best and stay tuned for more videos. You don't forget to like, share and subscribe to this channel. Bye-bye. See you.